Guillaume Meng go high for the rebound, loses it, but it bounces to Christian Moriker. Lob, Krejci! Woo!
Long off the back iron. Meng out in front with the big finish.
What a flush by Meng.
Krauser on the wing. And a good block out by Krejci. Numbers 3-on-1 to Moriker. And Pacific has answered the Pittsburgh run.
Yeah, some of the teams that are in the conference have an extremely low RPI.
There he goes!
He called it.
It wasn't down the middle, but at least it was on the baseline.
Double E has numbers. And it's a wide open web. Make it 5-4-5. Oh, the web we weave at Pacific.
Pacific coming the other way in a 2-2 game. Moriker. Double team, kicks it back out to Doubley.
The lead is up to 6, and Bobby Braswell wants a timeout.
The 2004-2005 season was a spectacular year for Pacific basketball and head coach Bob Thomason. Singled out as one of the top mid-majors in the entire nation, the Tigers climbed as high as the 16th-ranked team in the country. Along the way, Pacific was 18-0 in conference, and their 22-game winning streak was the longest in the nation. While they've been dominating over the last two seasons on the hardwood, the Tigers are also the winningest team on the West Coast over the last 2 years. To get some idea just how powerful Thomason's Tigers have become, 2 years ago, Pacific won 25 games and lost 3 seniors. Last season, they came back to nail down 27 victories. The last 2 seasons, Pacific has also run roughshod over the Big East in the NCAA tournament, with victories over Providence and Pitt, as the Big West has dominated the Big East at the Big Dance. Overall, Pacific had the best winning percentage in the country since January 1st, 2004. And in the last 2 years of conference action, the Tigers have gone 35-1, winning 30 straight in Big West Conference play. In terms of individual honors, for the second year in a row, Pacific had the MVP in the conference with David Doubley. And 6 players from this past year's team were named to the Big West All-League team. Coach Bob Thomason was named Big West Coach of the Year, the 2004-2005 Hugh Durham Mid-Major Coach of the Year, and also the USBWA District 9 Coach of the Year. In a season marked by outstanding victories, they also pulled off what ESPN called the greatest comeback of the year, when Pacific, down by 7 with 28 seconds to go on the road to Utah State, rallied to win at the buzzer. Pacific simply had the best road winning percentage in the country, with their lone loss at Kansas in a game in which the Tigers laid the wood to the Jayhawks, but just came up short on the scoreboard. The season started early this past year with a great run in Canada, and the Tigers never eased off the throttle. Pacific had non-conference wins over Santa Clara from the WCC, and then they hammered the WAC with victories over San Jose State, Nevada, Fresno State, and UTEP, and the bracket buster on ESPN's marquee game. Pacific continued to climb in the rankings throughout the year with a never-say-die team refused to lose. This was all accomplished against the backdrop of arguably the very best place to play on the West Coast in the sold-out Spano Center, where fans arrived early and partied late into the night, celebrating win after win after win. Conversely, because of their exciting up-tempo style of unselfish team play, the Tigers were also a great road draw for other universities, fed off of Pacific's tremendous record. As always, the hallmark of Pacific basketball and head coach Bob Thomason is a team concept that places the emphasis on sacrificing for the good of the team. And that has meant back-to-back trips to the NCAA tournament and glory for the Pacific Tigers.
Tigers have it regardless. With the momentum, Dudley to bring the house down. Yes!
It does. Great spread court offense. There's where defense creates offense. The Tigers get the rebound, get the numbers on the spread court. Dudley's able to take his time and take the shot from the outside and drain it.
Senior guard David Dudley, the MVP of the league and the Big West Player of the Year, led the Tigers in 2005. Pacific's team captain with a never-say-die attitude, Dudley was a clutch free-throw shooter with a 90% career mark, and he was an exceptionally good three-point shooter, hitting trays at a 39% clip. David's willingness to take the big shot and make the big play, along with his ability to lead the Tigers to victory, became a trademark for Pacific this past year. Dudley will complete his degree this summer, and we look forward to watching him play pro ball. Senior Guillaume Yango gave the Tigers a quick physical presence inside. He ended the year as the team's leading scorer and rebounder. Yango was an outstanding low-post defender and a great shot blocker who closed out his career as Pacific's seventh all-time shot rejector. Yango evolved to become a big-time player who became consistent on both ends of the floor. The native of Paris, France, also became another European big man who flourished under the Pacific coaching staff. Yango graduated in May with a degree in communications, and he'll be playing pro ball in Europe, but he has his sights set on the NBA. Junior forward Christian Moriker is an extremely skilled big man who has the ability to play both inside and outside. The talented sharpshooter connected for nearly 40% from long distance, and he definitely has the potential to play in the NBA and become the first Swedish player in the league. A two-time Big West player, the Tigers are depending on Christian to lead them back to the NCAA tourney for the third straight year. A possible Big West Player of the Year candidate, Christian has an unbelievable jump hook, and it was his shot that nailed down the win against Utah State on the road. Senior Jasko Korajkic was another Swedish import who was an explosive athlete who made amazing plays coupled with great timing and a flair for the game. Jasko finished fourth on the all-time steals list, and he was the best open court player Pacific in decades. A tremendous rebounder from the three position, he graduated with a degree in business in May. He loved the crowd, and the crowd loved Jasko. A team co-captain, Jasko had four outstanding years at Pacific. Senior Tyler Newton was one of the most versatile players in the country. Tyler did a little bit of everything for the Tigers, playing the 3, 4, and 5 positions. Tyler was a great passer and an outstanding playmaker who had the ability to elevate, and he could dunk on anyone in the country. A two-time honorable mention All-Big West player, Newton could play wherever needed. He was very unselfish, and he just wanted to win. Newton graduated in May with a degree in communications, and he's now playing pro ball in Australia. Marko Mihailović was one of the most improved players in the country this past year. He had a very solid senior season, and night in, night out, he was one of the best defenders on the floor. Marko started strong and never eased off the throttle. An honorable mention all-conference player, Marco will be graduating this summer and playing pro ball in Europe. Matt Kemper is another player who had a great senior season. Another skilled big man, Kemper shot the ball at a 43% clip from three-point territory. He played his role with excellence, rebounded, and shot extremely well. Matt is on track to earn his master's degree this summer. He's currently playing pro ball in Australia. Senior Alan Purnell's year was hampered by an early season injury. However, his outstanding attitude made him a great teammate that supported the program at the highest level. Alan would graduate this summer with a degree in business. Guard Johnny Gray is an outstanding outside shooter. An explosive athlete with great energy who could burn the nets, Gray hit for a blistering 48% from three-point land. The talented guard is one of the players the Pacific will be counting on to lead the Tigers to a return to the big dance. A great athlete that seems faster with the ball, Johnny did a great job in 2005, and he's one of the Tiger spark plugs. Talented guard Mike Webb ended the season strong by lighting up Pitt in the NCAA tournament. Webb had the ability to hit six or seven trays from deep range, and he's the ultimate three-point shooter in the nation. An outstanding team player, Mike rallied for the Tigers in their road win over Utah State. Mike also has the wettest jumper on the West Coast. Just ask Pitt. Senior big man Miguel Flores is a crowd favorite and one of the strongest Tigers coming off the bench. Pacific is looking for Flores to make his presence felt this year on the inside. Michael White's a tough guy with a great work ethic and good low post moves. The coaching staff is looking for big things from both White and Flores this coming year. The Tigers will also be looking for extra firepower from both Anthony Brown and Kevin Hurley. What has really set Pacific apart over the years has been an outstanding coaching staff that ranks not only as one of the best on the West Coast, but also among the very finest in the nation. With the importance of continuity and experience, Ron Verlin anchors the staff, along with two outstanding former Tiger players, Adam Jacobson and Aaron Velichko, who both played for Coach Thomason. As always, the emphasis at Pacific is placed on a team atmosphere that allows student athletes to flourish in the classroom and also on the court.
Down the stretch, doubling left side, three-point circle along the base. Yango wide open, his jumper is good with 3.9 seconds remaining. Fitzgerald, three on the way, no good. Pacific escapes with a 67-65 victory.
Everybody's watching you now. Everybody waits for you now. What happens next? What happens next? I dare you. Welcome to the fallout. Welcome to resistance. The tension is here. The tension is here. Salvation is here.